Today's episode of Inside Gaming Daily is brought to you by Postmates. You can get $100 of free delivery credit for your first 7 days if you use our offer code INSIDE.
Hey everyone, welcome back to Inside Gaming for Wednesday.
Oh, Wednesday, it's hump day. Hey, this one's for all the game devs out there. It's a respectful hump.
There have been some controversies over at the Epic Games Store in the past, but nothing has come close to the giant show that we've seen over the last few days.
Yeah, and it's all over a cute little indie game named Ooblets, which is the best name ever.
If you're not familiar with the game, it's a life sim that's part Pokemon, part Stardew Valley. It's being made by a UK husband and wife team, and it's due out on the Xbox One and PC later this year.
Well, that just sounds adorable, heartwarming. It just touches me right here. Who could ever be upset at a game like this?
So cute.
There's no reason.
Well, I got four words for you. Epic Games Store exclusive.
Yeah, that makes sense then.
The whole mess started last week when designer Ben Wasser posted the news about the exclusivity deal on the game's site. He said that the PC version of the game was going to be exclusive to the Epic Game Store because Epic offered us a minimum guarantee on sales. Basically, that ensured that the game would at least break even.
How dare he?
But they also seem aware that this could spark a backlash like it has with a lot of other games.
Yeah, Wasser acknowledged that possibility, but didn't think it would affect Ooblets, writing, quote, "I don't expect much of our uniquely lovely community to fit into this weird anti-Epic contingent, but I figured I'd share our thoughts and have an open conversation about the issues."
Ooh, wow. Yeah, that one didn't age right.
Oh, you thought you were safe. You thought you were safe from the internet, but it finds you wherever you are. He then addressed some potential criticisms that Epic exclusives typically get. Specifically, that it's anti-consumer to have exclusives, and that the Epic Game Store doesn't have as many features as other storefronts. And a few other issues, but still, sometimes you see the poop in the room and you're just like, someone else, we're just gonna have to deal with that one.
Took a look at the room and said, goodbye. Signed right off by suggesting that if people are mad about Ooblets' exclusive deal, they should ask themselves, quote, if there might be anything just a tad more worthwhile to be upset about.
And he suggested, for example, climate change, human rights abuses, the new Twitter UI, or the last season of Game of Thrones.
Please stop.
He's just being, you know, he's just being charming and personable, but obviously the internet didn't take too kindly to any of that, right, Brian?
I think he was being a little cheeky, a little British humor that I've heard so much about, but it did not translate well to the internet.
Oi! They immediately accuse the developers of taking a rude and condescending tone with their customers, which, okay, yeah, some condescension, but it's the internet, man!
It's hard to read sarcasm in text form. We've all been there. We know it, right? You're supposed to do slash S.
Yeah, give it the sark mark.
Put a little smiley face at the end of that.
Yeah,
exactly. Wink. Yeah.
No offense, wink.
I'm gonna kill
your mom. No offense, wink.
So Reddit user Admiral Australia put it, they wanted the money Epic's throwing out. That's fine, but don't get so pissy when people complain about you taking it.
One person, though, was a huge fan of the announcement. Epic boss Tim Sweeney, who called it, quote, awesome. Many more people weren't very happy with it, and a storm ensued. It's basically like this positive feedback loop where people just whip each other into a frenzy.
Or a negative feedback loop. I don't know. Which one is it?
Yeah.
The game subreddit exploded with negative posts, and its Discord channel, which was previously just a handful of people, was flooded with angry people who were furious about the exclusivity deal.
Yeah, the developers initially interacted with some of the angry fans coming in, but that also rubbed players the wrong way. Like when developer Rebecca accordingly wrote in the Discord, quote, "I love that most people claiming to be longtime supporters of Ooblets literally joined the Discord 20 minutes ago." It's true, but you don't say
it. You're throwing gas on the fire.
Kind of, yeah.
Stop. Others posted screenshots of their own interactions with the developers, who seemed a bit annoyed at times and playfully condescending at others.
It all got screenshotted and just fed right back into the outrage bonfire.
Just dumping it on.
Yeah.
Imagine
developing a game for 3 years and you get a breakthrough and you get some money and then you're just being happy about it, you're playful, the pressure's off now, and all of a sudden people just dogpile on you and you're like, motherfucker! I've been working for 3 years. I get to be a little cheeky right now. This is the one thing I get.
Never. So all the posts contributed to a sense among some fans that the devs were being dismissive at best and rude at worst to their customers or potential customers, even though it's probably the case that 99.99% of these people will never buy Ooblets. But then, of course, some people apparently took it way too far and began personally harassing and threatening the developers.
Right. In a post on Medium yesterday, Wasser recapped the whole saga, saying they, quote, "were totally unprepared for the attention we got from the broader gaming/internet community, which was fueled by a deep misunderstanding of the tongue-in-cheek tone as condescending and patronizing." I'm gonna go out on a limb and say that some of them, I think, willfully misunderstood that, just so they could be mad, just throwing that out there. He also said that he was using a, quote, "light-hearted tone" with some critics to try and defuse the situation, which turned out to be a, quote, "stupid miscalculation on my part."
Miscalculation is a very popular word this week.
The mistake of trying to talk to people like they were adults.
Yeah, what else did he say, Brian?
Well, he shared some of the worst responses they got from gamers, which included death threats, rape threats, slurs, you name it, just the worst of humanity. Wasser wrapped up by saying, what happened to us is the result of people forgetting their humanity for the sake of participating in video game drama.
There were also multiple sub-controversies because, of course, that's what happens. For instance, the devs were supposedly being dismissive of a single parent in Malaysia who wanted to buy the game for his son, but he couldn't because the Epic Game Store didn't support his currency. It's not clear if that was fake or legit. It's awfully suspect, though.
As PC Invasion points out, the timestamps of the message are 7 hours apart, not to mention the screenshot has the two messages spliced together, so. Internet Court, it's yours.
And the tinfoil hats keep stacking up, right, Brian?
Yeah, one Discord user, this was probably the craziest. He became convinced that the developers were Chinese spies, and so to try to out them, he kept posting images of the Taiwanese flag, because apparently Chinese spies can't say Taiwan. I'm not really sure, it was weird.
Something like if you say it, your government will flag it, and then you go to jail.
Yeah, dudes like rappelling through the windows and drag you off to China jail, where you have to play Candy Crush all day.
All the harassment even led the game critic Jim Sterling to take down a video he made on the whole saga.
Sterling wrote yesterday on Twitter that he didn't want to indirectly encourage more harassment, tweeting, quote, in the wake of the Ooblets team being dogpiled, harassed, and threatened over their Epic exclusivity, I've made my video on the topic private for now.
Epic Games even responded to the backlash with a statement of its own, saying, quote, the announcement of Ooblets highlighted a disturbing trend which is growing and undermining healthy public discourse, and that's the coordinated and deliberate creation and promotion of false information, including fake screenshots, videos, and technical analysis accompanied by harassment of partners, promotion of hateful themes, and intimidation of those with opposing views.
Oh, so yeah, it's been a whole saga to say the least. Certainly, we've considered that you may derive more negative attention to the developers by covering the story in the first place. Please don't do that. If you're mad about this, be mad at us instead of them, or me specifically.
Please.
I've seen this happen and it really pisses me off. I get the initial punch of being like, hey, he shouldn't have talked that way. To me, I get that. Adults are just like, okay, I'm gonna take that emotion and just put it right in my pocket and go on with my day. It doesn't enable you to just be an asshole about the whole situation. Hit up my Twitter if you need to blow off some baby gamer rage, because I can take it.
He'll fight you for days.
I'm also not the one making a game for you guys. Like, acknowledge that. I get it, it's not exactly the way you want, but it actually occurred to me while we were reading this. I think a lot of it is the customer wants to feel like they're in control, and when Epic Game Store comes in and basically subsidizes the game, the customers lose control. Now the developers can say whatever they want. I see it so much of like, people think influencers have to grovel for your attention and your approval. I don't, so f me up. Bring it over here, that's what I say.
It was a good rant.
Thanks.
On this side too, having worked in this industry for over a decade now, I've met a lot of independent developers who do sweat the small stuff, especially putting their heart and soul into a game, and they're scared that it's not going to recoup its costs because they're literally mortgaging their house to make these games sometimes. It seems enticing for a big company to come and say, hey, we'll give you a guarantee. You're not going to fail. But I totally understand that it is a deal with the devil, especially on the internet. It's a bad look. So yeah. I see it on both sides, but at the end of the day, I end up siding with the person who is probably more affected by it and is the person making the game. I can see why they're doing it, but at the same time, I think they need to be more understanding of why people are upset.
That's 100% true. I think you do need to have a delicate tone when you're dealing with people that apparently have the most fragile egos in the world. And then, it basically means you need a PR manager, which is sad. But apart from that, one of our goals here at this show, and personally one of my goals, is try to promote and repair any amount of empathy between game players and game makers. As far as I can see, this is another sad example of how game developers are just not allowed to talk, at least not candidly. They're not allowed to joke because people take that stuff and weaponize it, at least not without a PR agency carefully screening everything they say to make sure people on the internet don't get ammunition to use it for a bad faith hate campaign.
I think we'd like to believe that gaming can still be a close-knit pastime, but when the gaming audience acts like this, it makes that nearly impossible for most people in the industry.
So we're not saying that this is entirely the fault of the gamers.
Rise up.
It sure looks like it's mostly the fault of gamers here. It's okay to be mad at the Epic Game Store. I'm not telling you it's not. It is a worse product, I get it. It's also okay to feel condescended by that original blog post, but that's life. You don't always get everything your way. An adult says, I didn't appreciate that, and then just moves on, goes to do something. A child gets so ass blasted that they have to hype themselves up on a subreddit to the point that they start circulating doctored images and trying to provoke the developers into responding. It's not good. Long story short, if you want to be treated like an adult, you have to act like one, and sometimes that means not trying to exact divine revenge because your feelings got hurt by a blog post on the internet.
But that's been a double standard for a really long time. People think you can say whatever you want to developers or C-tier online personalities, heyo, and they aren't allowed to say anything back because they're not people or something. I don't know, I've been on this side for a long time. People just shout stuff and I quietly just go about my day because it's a lot easier than engaging with someone that I'm gonna get into an internet argument with that results in nothing.
Again, if these sentiments upset you, direct all your anger to this guy right here.
Please.
Make me your little internet sock monkey, bash me around, let the developers make their game in peace the way that they want to, and make the decisions about how to sell their product.
Anyway, back to the story. Let's not forget that this is not the first time that people have been mad about a game becoming an Epic exclusive.
Oh, really? Oh, I thought this was the first time. No. Anyway, yeah, there have been a lot of them. Epic has made exclusive deals with high-profile games like The Division 2, Metro Exodus, and most recently, Borderlands 3.
But what are the devs doing, Brian?
Oh, sorry, I've just been over here writing an angry letter to Lawrence. Lots of developers have gone over to Epic because the company has been giving them a bigger share of the revenue that their games make. In Epic's case, developers get 88% of the revenue versus just 70% on Steam. And Tim Sweeney has said it's that revenue split that is driving Epic's hardball tactics. He's argued that Steam has benefited from having a monopoly in the PC marketplace, and he said that Epic will stop doing exclusive deals if Steam would agree to a similar revenue share.
Most consumers who are used to Steam have been annoyed by having to install another launcher, while others have been understandably pissed off after pre-ordering some games on Steam only to see them move to the Epic Games Store.
Those are very reasonable things to get upset with.
Absolutely.
I want to throw that out there. In response, we've seen the usual review bombs of games like Borderlands 3, and even allegations that the Epic Games Store is Chinese spyware. But with Ooblets, the whole backlash has burned hotter and longer than it normally has.
It could be because this is a much smaller dev team who doesn't have any kind of PR machine blocking for them.
Yeah, and since they try to communicate directly with the fans online, some took that access to hurl abuse at them, which was pretty clearly over the line.
But it also raises the question of how much does a developer owe their customers? Ooblets started development years ago, and it has a Patreon, so it's naturally a lot more give and take when it comes to direct supporters like that.
For sure, yeah. No, you owe them, I think, an element of politeness and directness. But What about potential customers? What do they deserve?
In his Medium post, Wasser said there's a strange relationship that some gamers have with developers, saying that, quote, these folks believe they hold the magic power of the wallet over developers who should cower before them and capitulate to any of their demands.
He has even less patience for what he called, quote, people using the term consumers and potential customers, who he accused of, quote, doing so specifically because we've never actually sold them anything and don't owe them anything at all.
Basically, he's saying that some people don't intend to ever buy the game. They're just jumping on internet pylon, which we have seen before. None of that's gonna calm down the mob.
Yeah.
We know that, obviously, it's the internet.
Yeah, it's another example of the internet being a great way to connect devs and their audience, especially in crowdfunding campaigns or Patreon communities.
In this case, a small game like Ooblets found itself in the center of a much bigger controversy in the gaming industry, and a tiny community suddenly found itself swarmed with angry, opinion-having hordes. I didn't know what this game was until we did this story.
Oh, so you're saying the Ooblets devs made all this up just so they could get free PR? Is that what you're saying? Adam. Wow, you're right. So yeah, that's how we end up in this whole mess that we're in right now. People have every right to be annoyed at the Epic Games Store exclusives. Threats are always a no-no. Please, please, please respect those boundaries.
Absolutely, yeah. This is also a great example of why developers should probably hire a PR firm, or I guess in that case, if you can't afford them, maybe don't talk, which sucks.
Yeah, you'd like to think that you can be honest with people and even maybe a little playful, but that gets misinterpreted, especially when people are mad at a launcher. I don't know, Brian, are you gonna run PR for Inside Gaming now?
Oh, do I get a raise? Yeah, I'll totally do it.
Are you running PR while you're writing the angry letters to Lawrence? How does that work? You're double dipping at that point.
You don't want me running PR. I just tell everybody to off and then finish shotgunning a beer.
The Skype cutting out was perfect.
Yeah, that was good censorship. Anyway. Right. Me up, internet.
Nah, they will.
Today's episode of Inside Gaming Daily is brought to you by Postmates, which will deliver whatever you want, wherever you want, whenever you want. That's right, we may not be able to buy games on whatever game store we want, but we can have whatever we want in the real world, wherever we want, when we want it. It's basically a delivery service for anything. Most recently, I used it for Jack in the Box, because when I feel like a total trash panda, it's time to get those chicken nuggets, it's time to get those tacos, it's time to get that Jumbo Jack. And I don't want to go outside for it. I'm too good for that. Why'd I gotta go out under the sun and where people are, and they look at me and they have to say things? No, don't need it. A few taps on your phone, you can just stay on the couch and never have to move. Postmates is your personal food delivery, grocery delivery, whatever kind of delivery service all year round, 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. No more trips to the store. Who cares? You don't even have to know where the store is. That is so 2015. We're done with that now. Now it's just couch. Couch, TV, video games, and anything you want right at your fingertips. We also have a special promo code for you guys. You can get $100 of free delivery credit in your first 7 days using Postmates. All you gotta do is use our code INSIDE. There's a little thing on the left. If you go to the menu, use offer code, type in INSIDE. $100 of free delivery credit for your first 7 days using Postmates. I recommend it because it really enables the true gamer lifestyle of sitting at the internet and getting mad about things. Once more, that's Postmates, $100 of free delivery credit using our offer code INSIDE. Thank you for supporting the show, Postmates, and thank you, Inside Gaming Viewer, for supporting our sponsors.
Out of context, that still makes sense.
Another day, another desperate move from the Epic Game Store to buy your love and acceptance.
It's almost like they played Stardew Valley as much as we did. If we give PC players enough carrots, they'll marry us eventually, right, Lawrence?
Oh, don't let me die alone on this farm! Oh, God. But I did make a Pikachu out of flowers, so that's cute.
That is cute, but you're still gonna die alone.